Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is going to be a tutorial for the look I was wearing in my top matte shadow palettes. It actually started as the all green matte look you just saw there, but I couldn't help but add a little shimmer over top, so to see how I got the look, let's get started. First, I'm using a primer. This is MUA's No-Crease Eyeshadow Primer, and I'm using my ring finger to apply that all over the moving part of my lid, up to beneath my eyebrow, as well as my lower lash line. Now, going into the shadow, I'm using the Viseart Dark Mattes palette, using that olive green shadow first and a flat shader to pat that all over my lid. Next, staying in that same Viseart palette, I'm going into the lightest brown shade here and a crease brush, and I'm using that to blend that olive green out. For continuity's sake, I also took a smaller detail brush and applied that same brown to my lower lash line. Then to add a little more shade variety to this look, I'm using the same flat shader as before and going into the slightly more emerald green in this palette and using that in my outer corner, really packing it on at first to build up the pigment, then blending it into that olive green shade, and then I took the same blending brush that I used for that brown on my crease to blend everything together. Then to blend out my crease shade so it's a little bit of a smoother gradient between that and my brow bone, I'm using another matte shadow palette. This is the Stila Eyes Are the Windows to the Mind palette. And I'm going in with a brown that's a little bit lighter than the one I had in my crease and using that just to blend it out and up. Then I'm doing something very similar, going into a lighter cream shade and applying that to my brow bone just so it looks a little bit like a smoother transition. Moving right along to liner, I'm using Lancôme's Liquid Pencil in Pacifique. I have been loving these for my waterline. They apply really, really smoothly, but as a lot of you may know, I have issues keeping pencil in my waterline, and sometimes if they're not smooth enough, they just pull and irritate. None of those problems with these, so I've been using them quite a bit in my recent tutorials. And then I'm applying mascara. This is L'Oreal's Voluminous Superstar. I'm just using the mascara end here because I knew I ultimately wanted to go in and use false lashes, so I'm not being super careful with my lashes here, just putting a few coats on them because I know they're going to get covered with some amazing lashes later. On to the rest of the face, I started with foundation. This little contraption is a Temp 2 Air. It's naturally from Temp 2, it's an airbrush makeup, but instead of using kind of the more traditional airbrush machines, this is a freestanding little thing that you can charge, put your AirPod in that works with the old machines. And so I already had my pods, got this, have really been liking it, so I might do a review in the future. But for now, I put it on the first power to start, and then I ramped it up to the second power, which is what those little light indicators on the back mean, and I just apply that, as you can see here, all over my face, lingering a little bit on any blemishes I have as well as my under eye area. Spending a little bit longer on those areas or ramping up your power will increase coverage. It just depends on how much coverage you want across the board. I'm sticking to traditional concealer for my under eyes. This is Amazing Cosmetics Amazing Concealer, one that I've really been liking lately. And I'm just using my ring fingers to apply that to my under eye area, and then any excess that I have on my fingers, I will just go and pat in particular problem areas like blemishes on my chin. But beyond that, your base is done. Moving along to the rest of the face, this is Laura Mercier's Bon Mine palette. I recently reviewed this. You can go check that out. I'll link it down below. And I'm using a fluffier buffing brush to apply the bronzer to the hollows of my cheeks, up into my temples, as well as below my jawline. Then, using the Duo Fiber Contour Brush from Real Techniques, I'm going into the lighter, more pinky-leaning blush from this palette and just stippling that all over my cheeks. Moving on to highlight, I'm using the lighter highlight of the bunch and stippling that on the tops of my cheekbones, the bridge of my nose, and my Cupid's bow. You know the drill. Nearing the end of this look, it's on to brows. This is the Hourglass Arch Brow Sculpting Pencil, and I'm just using that to shape and fill my brows. And last for this look, well, at least the first matte eye look, is lipstick. This is Charlotte Tilbury's Miss Kensington, which is a matte finish nude. And it's the perfect nude for me because it has slightly pink undertones, which keeps me from looking too dead, considering it's a nude lipstick. And that's it. That is everything you need to complete look number one, which is basically the matte look. Spoiler alert, look number two is not that hard. It is simply a duochrome shadow that I decided to pop on over top. The shadow that I'm using is actually the darker of two that you get in a Butter London shadow duo. This is in the duo Fancy Flutter, and these are meant to go in their shadow clutch. I've been super impressed with the quality of these shadows, so that's why I was eager to whip this one out. But the truth is, there are so many shadows like this out there that are similar. Nearly every brand has one. It's similar to MAC Blue Brown Pigment or their Club Eyeshadow. I think Makeup Geek has a similar shadow. Like I said, lots of brands have very similar shadows out there, but this is just the one that I had handy at the moment. And then I finished it up with the lashes. These are Makeup Forever's Natural Instincts, ones that I have been wearing in quite a few recent videos. I've really been liking them because the lash band looks so natural and they're very easy to apply. But that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.